jury, counselors, and people of the court. Bailiff, will you please swear the jury members in?
Jury, rise. Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I solemnly swear. To listen to the evidence presented in this case. To prove the guilt or innocence of the defendant. Say, I will. Be seated.
Thank you. At this time, I would like each of the lawyers to stand and introduce themselves, starting with the prosecution.
Good morning, Your Honor, ladies and gentlemen of the jury. My name is Antoinette Wilson, and I'm representing the people of the state of California in this action.
Good morning, Your Honor, ladies and gentlemen of the jury. My name is Melissa Kerrigan, and I am here today to represent the people of the state of California in this action.
Good morning, Your Honor, members of the jury. My name is Chris Babb, and I'm representing the people of California in this case.
Okay, thank you. Now, defense, will you please introduce yourselves?
Good morning, Your Honor, and ladies and gentlemen of the jury. My name is Masood Rahim, and I'm representing the defendant, Mr. Brad Stevens, in this case.
Good morning, Your Honor, ladies and gentlemen of the jury. My name is Mark Babb. I represent the defendant in this case, Brad Stevens.
Good morning, Your Honor, ladies and gentlemen of the jury. My name is Esteban Damar, and I'm representing the defendant in this case.
Okay, thank you. This pending case, the state of California versus the defendant Brad Stevens, an assault with a deadly weapon, violating section 245 of the California Penal Code, which states, the use of force or violence upon the person of another without consent, committed with an object used in such manner as to be capable of producing or likely to produce death or great bodily harm. If the members of the jury have any questions, please refer them to the jury foreman. Now we'll have the presentation of physical evidence by both sides. Prosecution, do you have any physical evidence you'd like to exhibit to the court at this time?
Yes, Your Honor. We would like this piece of wood labeled Exhibit A for prosecution.
Okay, bailiff, would you please show the physical evidence to the defense? Defense, do you have any objections?
No, Your Honor.
Okay. Prosecution, do you have any other physical evidence that you would like to exhibit at this time?
Yes, Your Honor. We would also like this black wallet labeled Exhibit B.
Okay. Bailiff, would you please show the wallet to defense? Defense, do you have any objections?
No objections.
Prosecution, any other physical evidence to exhibit at this time?
Yes, Your Honor. One more. We would like this knife labeled Exhibit C, please.
Okay. Would you please show that to the defense, bailiff? Defense, do you have any objections?
Objections.
Okay, thank you. Any other physical evidence at this time?
No, Your Honor, that would be all.
Okay. Defense, do you have any physical evidence to exhibit to the court at this time?
Yes, Your Honor. The defense would like the map of the arcade labeled Exhibit A.
Okay. Bailiff, would you please show
defense
this?
Defense Exhibit A.
Prosecution, you have any objections at this time?
No, Your Honor.
Okay. Defense, do you have any other physical evidence to exhibit at this time?
No, Your Honor.
Okay. Now we are ready to start the trial, which requires you, the jurors, your utmost attention. I am aware that you've all been sworn in. However, let me remind you that it's solely your responsibility to weigh all the facts and the facts only. Not any opinions or conclusions you may have about the case. It is your responsibility to weigh the facts to determine a verdict of guilty or not guilty. We will now hear opening statements from each side, the defense and the prosecution. Please remember that an opening statements are simply an outline of the case in the counselor's own words, for hopes to help you, the jury, to become familiar with the events in the case. Prosecution, if you are ready, please step forward and present your opening statement.
Thank you, Your Honor. Good morning, Your Honor.
Hi.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen of the jury. My name is Melissa Kerrigan, and I am here today to represent you, the people of the state of California. I want to sincerely extend my gratitude for your all being here today. Within the next few days, you will be hearing testimonies to either prove the defendant guilty or not. The reason that we took the time to carefully select you from many other people is because we are aware that you are here to be conscientious, fair, and most of all, we are certain that you will base your decision strictly on the facts presented here. The evidence presented will indicate, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, that on the night of June 4th at 8 p.m., the defendant, Mr. Brad Stevens, did violently and with no justifiable cause take a weapon and brutally attack Mr. Martin Mann in the face. The facts show that Brad Stevens used such an immense amount of force that he was able to render Mr. Martin Mann unconscious, as well as crush the cartilage in Mr. Mann's face, which required immediate medical attention. Over the course of this trial, we will prove, ladies and gentlemen, that this incident between two willing participants, Mr. Brad Stevens and Mr. Martin Mann, was not right. This is a case of a vicious act by a coward who, prior to this attack, had been sorely embarrassed in front of his date. Now, keep in mind that the burden of proof beyond a reasonable doubt lies on the prosecution. This testimony will show that Mr. Brad Stevens had a motive for his actions. Mr. Brad Stevens' motive was that he wanted to get revenge for being humiliated in front of his date. Being that it was their first time on a date, Brad Stevens wanted to make a good impression. Now, the defense may try and convince you that it was an act of self-defense, but let me illustrate to you that Mr. Brad Stevens did have a choice. So, let me remind you to listen carefully to the testimonies presented by both sides, and do not let the defense fool you into thinking that it was self-defense. I'll just remind you that Mr. Stevens did, in fact, have a choice. We are certain that you will see through this devious plan that the defense will try to present, and in an effort to allow another violent and guilty criminal to remain unpunished for his crimes. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Defense, are you ready? If you're ready, you can please step forward and present your opening statements.
Thank you, Your Honor. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen of the jury. I hope everyone's feeling well today. My name is Mark Lamb, and I represent the defendant, Brad Stevens. We would prove that Brad Stevens acted in self-defense and therefore is innocent of his charges. And it should be Mr. Martin Mann right there that should be on trial, because he was the first one who assaulted Mr. Brad Stevens. Distinguished members of the jury, we have selected you out of many potential jurors because we felt that you were the best. We know that with an honest heart, conscientious soul, and knowledgeable mind, you would try this case intelligently, fairly, and without bias. On the night in question, Brad Stevens and his date, Tanya Morgan, were at the Milanese Arcade playing their favorite game, Rogers. The two then had to go get some change. Upon returning, getting change, and reaching the parking machine, they encountered Mr. Martin Mann and his date, Connie Cook. Brad then politely asked Mr. Mann to play another game. A few more words were exchanged, and the next thing that happened was Martin Mann, in temperament, pushed Brad Stevens to the ground, injuring his wrist. And then, after Brad Stevens laid on the ground, injured, Mr. Martin Mann made advancements towards him and had to be restrained by the two dates, Connie Cook and Tanya Morgan. But while being restrained, Mr. Martin Mann made threats at Brad Stevens. He said to the effect, "The next time I see you, I will hurt you further." Brad Stevens and Tanya Morgan saw that this situation could be avoided, so they decided to leave. Upon leaving, they stopped by a drinking fountain to wash the blood that was covering Mr. Stevens' right hand. While they were washing their hands, Mr. Stevens looks up and sees Mr. Mann coming quickly towards him and pulling something out of his back pocket, and in the dimly lit arcade appeared to be a knife. Mr. Stevens did the only thing anyone would have done in this case to protect himself and his date. He picked up a piece of wood and with one swing, only one swing, hit Mr. Mann. Anyone in this
situation, you must agree, ladies and gentlemen, the juror, acted on their right of self-defense. And let me read you what self-defense means in the state of California. Self-defense stated in general, a victim of an actual or apparent deadly attack is justified in killing his assailant if such force is reasonably necessary to avert a threatened harm. Distinguished jurors, our client, Brad Steven, has been unjustly portrayed and accused by the prosecution. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, please take a look at Brad Stevens. He sits there in that chair, an innocent man. I'm sure you all know very well that a person, man or woman, is innocent until proven guilty in a fair trial. And that burden of proof lies on the prosecution, and they must prove it to you beyond a reasonable doubt. Let me repeat that again. The burden of proof lies on the prosecution, and they must prove it to you beyond a reasonable doubt. That means that if you have any doubt in your mind, when all evidence is heard, you must vote Brad Stevens not guilty.
Okay, thank you, defense. I understand that the defendant Brad Stevens pleads not guilty in this to this charge. Is that correct, defense?
Yes, Your Honor.
Does the defendant wish to change his plea?
No, Your Honor.
Okay. Prosecution, we can start the case by calling your first witness to the stand.
Your Honor, I would like to call Mr. Martin Mann to the stand, please.
Okay, Martin Mann, please approach the stand. Bailiff, would you please swear this witness in?
Bailiff, can you make sure that the microphone is turned so that it's as close to the person speaking as possible if we have problems with power? Each witness, yeah, maybe even slide it back a little bit. Like the whole thing back towards, back towards the wall. I'm going to just make sure.
Westdale High.
Do you remember the night of June 4th?
Yes.
What happened?
I was at Melanie's Video Arcade.
And who were you with?
Connie Cook.
Is there a particular machine you like?
Yes.
And this is?
Frogger.
Was there anyone playing it?
No.
Did you play it?
Yes.
And how were you doing?
Good.
What happened before this?
Put my money inside.
What happened next?
While I was playing, I noticed Mr. Brad Stevens to my left. He said in an angry voice, I should leave because that's his machine.
Objection, Your Honor. It's opinion, speculation.
Objection sustained. Please regard that, disregard that from your mind, jury.
Was Brad Stevens with anyone?
Yes.
Who?
Tanya Morgan.
What happened next?
He then came over and tried to take over the game while I was playing.
What did you do?
Nothing. I told him, leave me alone. Let me finish playing.
Did you do anything else, Mr. Mann?
Well, he continued to elbow me out of the way, so I pushed him away.
How hard would you say you pushed him?
Not very hard.
This is very important. I want you to stand beside me and push me the same way you did to Mr. Stevens that night. Could you do that?
Yes.
Okay, please do that. Thank you, Mr. Mann. Now, previously you've told us that Brad failed. Is this correct?
Yes.
Now, the way you pushed me couldn't possibly have made Mr. Stevens fall.
Objection, Your Honor. Cause for a conclusion.
Sustained. Jury, please disregard that question.
After Brad fell, what happened next?
Went to pick, help him up.
Did you threaten Brad?
Objection.
No.
Objection. Please advise the witness to stick to the fact sheets.
Overruled. Continue questioning, please.
Oh. What was your first thought when Brad fell?
I was concerned.
Did you know he was injured?
No.
How did you feel when you found this out?
I was quite concerned.
What did Ms. Cook and Ms. Morgan do?
They restrained me.
Was Connie upset?
Yes.
And what happened next?
She suggested that we should leave.
Mr. Mann, are you the kind of person that is in a hurry?
Not usually.
Were you in a hurry out the door that night?
Yes.
What was in your head?
Well, unfortunate situation. Just wanted to get out. Wanted to go back to her house.
Did you in fact leave the arcade?
I was on my way out.
Were Mr. Stevens and Ms. Morgan still in the arcade?
I don't know.
What happened to keep you from leaving?
I was attacked.
What happened next?
I remember waking up in the hospital.
Are you a violent person?
No.
Do you carry any weapons?
Never.
Do you carry a wallet?
Yes.
What color is it?
Black.
Mr. Mann, do you have any medical problems?
Yes.
What are they?
Irrelevant. Objection, Your Honor. Questions irrelevant to the case.
Overruled. Please continue with your question.
After I was attacked, I have a lot of nasal problems, I have problems breathing, can't smell.
Have you suffered?
Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Mann. I have no further questions, Your Honor. Would you like to cross-examine this witness?
Yes, Your Honor. May I approach the witness?
Yes, you may.
Your Honor, could you instruct the witness to ask the questions?
Would you please answer all the questions, yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, Mr. Mann, could you tell me where you went the night of June 4th?
Melanie's video action.
Is it true that you broke the law that night?
No.
You did. Did you know pushing someone without consent is assault?
No.
It is. Did you not cause bodily harm to my client by pushing him with your hand?
No.
Your Honor, could you please instruct the witness to stick to the facts?
Would you please just state facts only and no opinions?
Yeah.
Did you have Mr. Stevens' permission to push him?
No.
Then, Mr. Mann, you committed assault with a deadly weapon before my client even hit you with the stick. Mr. Mann, did you say anything to my client?
Yes.
What did you say?
I implied that.
Objection, Your Honor. He's supposed to answer all the questions, yes or no?
Sustained.
Your Honor. Can you
instruct the witness?
Yeah.
Would you please answer all the questions, yes or no, ma'am?
Yes.
Did you say something to the effect of, if I see you again, I'll beat you up?
No.
Did you threaten my witness at all?
No.
You didn't say nothing to my client?
Yes, I said something to him.
Is it true the arcade is dimly lit?
Yes.
Is it true you were in a hurry that night?
Yes.
You say that you tried to help my client up. Is that true?
Yes.
But then you also stated that the two girls had to restrain you. How can you help them up if you're being restrained? That's not possible, is it? Is it?
Yes.
Objection, Your Honor. That's irrelevant.
No, that's very relevant. She said that it's testimony. Because he said that he was restrained. How are you supposed
okay,
to help
can I
him
please
up?
Ask two lawyers approach the bench and need to
okay, at this time, you see the lawyers are having a little argument. They're not supposed to argue in front of the jury, so the judge is going to have
can
one lawyer.
Can I get one lawyer
from
the prosecution to approach the bench?
Out of the jury, she's going to listen to the arguments of each of them and make a decision whether or not to sustain or overrule the judge.
He said that he was restrained, but he also said that he tried to help him up. How is he going to help him up if he's being restrained? It's not possible. He said that he was going to help him up.
He was restrained from his girlfriend.
Exactly.
But he stated that he tried to help the witness up before he was restrained.
He said that he goes,
He goes, I was restrained. He goes, but I tried to help him.
Okay, I'm going to have you repeat the question from the restrained and repeat the question from trying to help him up. And then we'll go from there. Okay?
Mr. Mayor,
can I
ask you a question again? You said that you tried to help my client up.
Yes.
You also said you were restrained.
Yes.
It's not possible to help somebody up while being restrained. I attempted to help him up.
Steve? Yes or no?
Yes or no questions?
Can
I have 10 seconds?
Yes, you may. Yes, would you please answer all the questions, Mr. Mann, yes or no?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so you try to help him up while you're being restrained.
Yes.
That's possible.
It's
not. No, it's not possible. That's what I want to do. Isn't it true to leave the arcade, you must walk by the water fountain?
Yes.
The water fountain where Mr. Stevens and Mr. Morgan was?
Yes.
On your way out, did you not reach behind you and make a motion of taking something out of your back pocket?
Yes.
So after assaulting my client, then threatening his life, you hurried towards him and in a dimly lit place, reached behind you and pulled something out, correct?
No.
That's not correct.
Yes.
And in a dimly lit place, if you pull something out of your back pocket, that's that. Could that, you can't see as well in a dimly lit place.
Objection, that's a compound question.
Okay, would you please have one question?
In a dimly lit place, can you see as well as you could in a well lit place? So, for instance, if you're walking towards him and pulling something black out of your back pocket, you would not be able to tell exactly what it was. Yeah. You could tell what it was. In a dimly lit place. A black object.
Well,
pulling out from behind you. I didn't think so.
Objection, Your Honor.
No further questions.
Okay, Mr. Mann, you may step down. Prosecution, you may call your next witness. I need order in the court, please.
County
Cook, would you please approach the stand? Bailiff, would you please swear this witness in?
Okay, Your Honor, would you please instruct the lawyers, speak up a little bit? You're kind of talking to the witness. Make sure you turn out this way.
Okay.
Your Honor, may I approach the witness?
Yes, you may.
Good morning.
Honey.
Can you please say your full name to the court?
Honey Cook, C-O-O-K.
Ms. Cook, can you please speak loud and clear so the judge can hear you? You attend school?
Yes, I do.
Where?
I'm at West Hill High.
How long have you known Mr. Mann?
I don't know. That was our first date.
Your Honor, would you instruct both the lawyers and witnesses to speak up?
Okay, I need the lawyers and the witnesses to please speak up. If you need help with the mic, we can get that for you.
Okay.
Are you aware of what happened on the night of June 4th?
Yes, I am.
Can you tell the court what happened?
Martin Mann and I were on our first date, and we went to Melanie's video arcade. And his favorite game is Frogger, so we went to an occupied Frogger game, and he put in his coin, and he started playing. And Brad Stevens and his date, Tanya Morgan, came over, and Brad Stevens said, beat it, because he wanted to play the game, I guess. And then.
Objection, Your Honor, cause of speculation.
Overruled. Please continue with the question with the answer.
He said beat it and to get away from the game. So Brad Stevens was talking to Martin, and
Excuse me, Your Honor.
You don't have to have you speak into the phone because I can't hear anything.
Into
the
answer. Brad Stevens, they exchanged some words and he tried to push Martin out of the game and Martin ended up pushing him just a little bit.
Objection, Your Honor, that causes speculation, pushing a little bit.
Sustained. Jury, will you please disregard that answer?
What happened after Martin pushed Brad?
Well, it looked as if, Brad, like, tripped over his own feet.
Objection, Your Honor, speculation.
Constable.
Sustained. Jury, please disregard that answer.
What happened next?
Brad and Tanya left, and I told Martin that I wanted to leave, so we got up and left. And I seen Brad from, we were 6 or 7 feet away from the door, and I seen Brad pick up a stick or a piece of wood. And I didn't have enough time to warn Martin that it looked as if he was going to hit him.
Objection, Your Honor, speculation.
Overruled.
Yeah, may I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may.
Could you tell her to speak loud? Can we hear her?
Dr. Short, is there any way we can move the mic so it's like right in front? No.
That's what you do. You just need to speak into it. We could move the chair closer to the mic.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Okay, go ahead. Continue.
Ms. Cook, how do you think Brad felt?
Objection, Your Honor. Possible conclusion, too.
Sustained.
Ms. Cook, did you notice Tanya and Brad Stevens as you were leaving?
Yep, speak up. Counselor can't hear you.
Yes, I did.
Could you please tell the court what they were doing?
They were at the door, and we were walking out. They were just at the door. They were getting ready to leave.
Did you say anything to them?
No, I didn't.
Did you, in fact, leave Melanie's video arcade?
Yeah. No, we didn't.
Why weren't you able to leave?
Because Martin was attacked.
Can you tell the court by who?
Martin was attacked by Brad Stevens.
Ms. Cook, did you see Brad Stevens coming toward Martin?
Yes, I did.
Can you tell me how he attacked Martin?
Objection, Your Honor. It calls for an opinion.
Overruled. Continue with your question.
Just repeat it.
Miss Martin.
Miss Cook.
Sorry. Miss Cook. Did Brad Stevens hit?
That was overruled. It means you can ask the question.
Oh. Did you see Brad Stevens coming toward Martin with a piece of wood?
Yes, I did.
Is this Exhibit A the piece of wood that you...
Yes. Yes.
Did you warn Martin that Brad was coming?
No, because... Wait, say it again.
Did you warn Martin?
No, it happened so quickly that I wasn't able to warn Martin.
And what happened next?
Objection, Your Honor, question is too vague.
Your Honor, may I have a 10-second recess?
Yes.
Why don't you rule on the
objection? Is overruled. You can continue with the question, or you can have your 10-second recess.
Thank you.
that 10 seconds might be up. Go ahead and continue.
Ms. Cook, can you identify the defendant Brad Stevens?
Yes.
Can you please point him out to the court?
It's him right there. That's Brad Stevens.
Did you see Richard Cervantes that night?
Yes, I did.
Can you tell me what he was doing?
When I saw him, he was bringing in Brad Stevens by the arm.
Thank you. No further questions.
Okay, thank you. Ms. Vance, would you like to cross-examine this witness at this time?
Yes, Your Honor. May I push the witness?
Yes, you may.
Good morning, Ms. Cook. Please relax. I'm just going to ask you a few questions. You must think a great deal of Mr. Mann.
Yes.
Is it true that you were anxious to go home and spend some time alone?
No, I wasn't. Wait, what?
Could you
please answer the question? Objection, Your Honor, irrelevant to the case.
Overruled. You can continue with the question.
Could you?
Yes. Would you please answer all the questions, just yes or no?
Yes.
Is it true that you were anxious to go home and spend some time alone with Mr. Mann?
No.
That's not true?
Yeah. Well, yes, it is.
So you must have been upset when this alone time was interrupted with what happened. Isn't that true?
Yes.
Ms. Cook, isn't it safe to say that you would like to date Mr. Mann again?
Objection, yeah. Your Honor. That irrelevant to the case.
Overruled. Continue with your question.
Please answer the question.
Yes.
And with his nose broken, his appearance has changed. Do you still feel the same way about him?
Objection, Your Honor. Of course you do. Sustained. Jury, please disregard the question and answer.
Well then, Ms. Cook, couldn't we assume that you're going to shave the truth a little bit?
Objection, Your Honor. Calls for an opinion.
Would you repeat the question louder? Okay, we can't.
Yeah, we need
turn
to speak up
way.
Just a little bit more from now on.
Ms. Cook, couldn't we assume that you would shave the truth a little bit on the witness stand today?
No. Your Honor, for asking the witness.
Overruled.
Please answer the question.
No.
You wouldn't shade the truth to help out your date after his nose was broken?
No.
You wouldn't?
No.
It's really like
what? What is your point?
Shh. Ms. Cook, isn't it true that Mr. Mann pushed Mr. Stevens on the night of June 4th?
Yes.
And following this push, isn't it true that Mr. Stevens fell to the floor and injured himself?
Well, I don't know if he injured himself.
Yes or no.
Again, this could be the last time. We're going to have to speak up or we're going to have to just
okay,
the
we're
trial.
Gonna,
everybody's got to hear it, Kayvon. You're
if I'm
not speaking out here.
Instructing yes or no
speak
questions,
out here and
we
speak
need to
into
answer yes or no. And we need to speak up much louder or else this case is going to be irrelevant.
Could you repeat it, please?
And following this push, isn't it true that Mr. Stevens fell to the floor and injured himself?
Yes.
Isn't it safe to say the push given by Mr. Mann caused injury to Mr. Stevens?
Irrelevant, Your Honor. Objection does not state that in the fact sheet.
Yes, it does.
It does.
Objection. Can I please have two lawyers push bins or one lawyer from each side?
Isn't it safe to say the push given by Mr. Mann caused injury to Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
Isn't it also true that you and Ms. Morgan had to step in front of Mr. Mann as he started to step towards Mr. Stevens while he was on the floor?
Yes.
Ms. Cook, are you a mind reader?
No,
please, please.
Objection, Your Honor, irrelevant.
The back of the room needs to hear that question. Would you answer it again?
Ms. Cook, are you mind reading?
Objection, Your Honor, that is irrelevant.
Overruled. Continue with the question.
Could you please answer the question?
No.
So you don't know what was going through Mr. Mann's mind as he took those steps towards Mr. Stevens while he was on the floor, do you?
No.
Then isn't it possible that Mr. Mann could have been thinking of readily harming Mr. Stevens?
Objection, Your Honor. Calls for an opinion.
Sustained. Jury, would you please disregard the question and answer?
Well, you must have been quite shocked when Mr. Mann tried to attack Mr. Stevens while he was on the ground.
What? Objection, Your Honor, calls for another opinion.
You instructed the witness to answer yes or no questions that would imply much more than a yes or no answer.
Yeah.
You were shocked?
Wait, I didn't have to answer that.
Could you please ask the question again? It needs to be a yes or no answer question.
You must have been shocked when Mr. Mann tried to attack Mr. Stevens while he was on the ground. May I have a 10-second recess?
Yes,
Isn't it true that the...
Continue the question.
Could you please instruct the witness to answer
yes? Would you please answer all the questions, yes or no?
Yes.
Is it true that the arcade was dimly lit?
Yes.
And isn't it true that you can't see as well in a dimly lit place as you can see in a well-lit place?
Yes.
So in fact, it was difficult for anyone to see what you and Mr. Mann were doing as you were leaving the arcade.
Objection calls for an opinion.
Sustained. Jury, please disregard that question. Continue with another question, Counselor.
No further questions.
Thank you. You may step down, Ms. Cook. At this time, we are going to have to continue tomorrow at the same time. Let me remind you, the jurors, that you are not to talk to any lawyers, witnesses, or subject yourself to any outside information such as news, radio, or TV. We will continue tomorrow at the same time. Court is adjourned.
All right, thank you for coming. And this side is the defense side. They have been hired by Mr. Brad Stevens because he has been accused of assault and battery. He is claiming that he had a legal right to do what he did, which was take this piece of wood and smash this gentleman right here by the name
Objection.
Of Mr. Martin Mann across the
Objection.
Nose.
Objection. Smash.
This person is claiming that he did it in self-defense. Of course, you're going to have to be prepared to try to decide. Doug, would you want to come on in and have a seat? Welcome, gentlemen.
Do they have to be here?
So, where we're at in the trial so far is we are in the second day. They have put two witnesses. They have had two witnesses on the witness stand that have testified to what happened on that night. And they will be calling two more witnesses, and then you will be able to see the defense call all of their witnesses in its entirety. So you really shouldn't miss too much. I will answer any questions. We just ask that you conduct yourself like you would in a regular courtroom. Your demeanor has to be that of listening carefully, just like as if you were a jury member. And hopefully your teacher will give you a small quiz at the end of this exercise to see what you've learned. And at least if you haven't learned anything else, you should know what prosecution means, you should know what defense means, you should know what direct examination of a witness means, you should know what cross-examination of a witness means. You should also know what some of the objections, these lawyers will be objecting to certain things that the other lawyers are trying to do because they think they're not fair. So listen to some of the objections. For example, the objection of irrelevant means that whatever is being asked is really not necessary in this court. It doesn't have anything to do with the case. Anybody have any questions before we start? I think you'll enjoy it and learn something at the same time.
Oh. All rise. Superior Court of the State of California in the County of San Diego, Courtroom 503 is now in session. The Honorable Mary Jane Platt presiding.
You may all be seated. Good morning, jury members, counselors, and people of the court. We're beginning the second day of the trial of Brad Stevens versus the State of California. And I'll read the charge to you again. This pending case, the State of California versus defendant Brad Stevens, an assault with a deadly weapon violating section 245 of the California Penal Code. Bailiff, would you please swear in the jury?
Jury rise. Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I solemnly swear. To listen to the evidence presented in this case. To decide the guilt or innocence.
We left off the other day with the cross-examination of Connie Cook, and she stepped down, and we will now proceed with the prosecution bringing up the next witness. Who would you like to call up?
Your Honor, I would like to call Richard Cervantes to the stand.
Richard Cervantes, would you please approach the stand? Bailiff, would you please swear this witness in?
Raise your hand. Do you promise that the testimony you gave is the truth? What you think about the truth? Say hello.
Hello.
Say your full name and spell your last.
Richard Cervantes, C-E-R-V-A-N-T-E-S.
Okay, you see.
May I approach the witness, Your Honor?
Yes, you may.
Good morning. Please state your full name to the court.
Richard Cervantes.
Mr. Cervantes, I would like for you to relax. Please speak loud and clear so the judge and the jury may hear you. And remember that you've taken an oath. Mr. Cervantes, what is your occupation?
Manager of Melanie's Video Arcade.
And how long have you been working there?
5 years.
Do you see many high school kids coming in?
Yes, I do.
And how do you feel about working with them?
It's a pretty good position.
Do you know many of them?
No, I don't.
Do you know Martin Nash?
No, I don't.
Do you know Brad Stevens?
No.
Where were you the night of June 4th around 8:15 p.m.?
I was working the front counter at the arcade.
Did you notice Brad Stevens and Tanya Morgan?
Yes, I did.
Could you please tell the court where they were?
Near the fountain.
Could you tell by the expression on their faces what they were feeling?
Objection, Your Honor. Call for opinion.
Objection sustained. Jury, disregard that question. You may proceed with another question.
What were they doing?
They were talking.
Did you hear anything they said?
Objection, no personal knowledge.
Overruled, continue with the question.
They were talking. I overheard Brad saying to Tanya to leave him alone or leave it alone.
Your Honor, may I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may.
I assumed I saw Martin walking to the front.
Objection, Your Honor. Opinion.
Overruled. Continue with the question.
Go. I saw him walking to the front counter, near the front.
What was he doing?
He was pulling out his wallet.
Mr. Cervantes, does this look like the wallet that you saw?
Yes, it does.
How did you notice it was a wallet he was pulling out of his pocket?
I see many kids or people coming into the front counter.
Overruled. Continue with the answer.
I'll repeat it again. How did you notice it was a wallet Martin Mann was pulling out of his pocket?
I see many people coming up to the front counter to ask me for change.
So it wasn't a knife?
No, it wasn't.
Is there anything that would make you want to lie for Mr. Mann?
No.
How about Mr. Stevens?
No.
What happened after Martin took out his wallet?
He was struck by Brad Stevens.
What happened next?
All I heard was a yell and he fell to the floor.
Where did Brad get the piece of wood?
He got it from a windowsill that we use to prop open a window on hot days.
Was Connie around?
Yes.
What was she doing?
She was standing behind Martin.
What was Brad doing?
He was standing beside Martin.
Where was the stick?
It was in Brad's hand.
What happened next?
Brad dropped the stick and ran.
And what did Connie do?
She ran to Martin's side.
Your Honor, may I have a 10-second recess?
Yeah, sure. We need to proceed.
Mr. Cervantes, could you identify Mr. Brad Stevens if you saw him in this courtroom?
Yes, I could.
Do you see him?
Yeah, he's sitting over there.
And is this the stick you saw Brad Stevens holding?
Yes, that is.
Mr. Cervantes, what happened after Brad left?
I followed him out. He was running out and I followed him.
How fast was he running?
He was trying to get out of it pretty quick.
Speculation.
Overruled. Continue with the question.
I'll repeat it again. How fast was he running?
He was trying to leave pretty quick.
Were you able to catch up to him?
Yes, I did.
What was going through his mind?
Objection. No personal knowledge.
Sustained. Jury, disregard that question. Continue with another question, please.
Mr. Cervantes, did you say anything to him?
I asked him why he did it.
And what did he say?
He said he just had to. He had to hit him.
What happened next?
I grabbed him by the arm and brought him back to the arcade.
And what happened to the stick?
When the police got there, I picked it up and I gave it to him.
Mr. Cervantes, what was going through your mind when this incident occurred?
I was shocked.
How do you compare it with others?
I can't compare
Objection.
Overruled. Continue with that question.
Mr. Cervantes, how do you compare this incident with others?
I can't compare it. It's never happened.
Sustained. Jury, disregard that question.
No further questions,
Anna. Okay, thank you. Defense, would you like to cross-examine this witness?
Yes, Your Honor. May I approach the witness?
Yes, you may.
Good morning, Mrs. Cervantes. I'm going to ask you a few questions. Just relax. Tell the truth. Mrs. Cervantes, on the night of June 4th, do you remember what took place?
Yes, I do.
Do you remember Mrs. Stevens and Ms. Morgan walking to the water fountain?
Yes.
You
have to speak out. Yes. Just
Could you instruct the witness to answer the questions? Yes, please.
Would you please answer all the questions yes or no, Mr. Cervantes?
Yes.
Thank you.
Do you remember Mrs. Stevens and Ms. Morgan walking to the water fountain?
Yes.
Did you find anything unusual about that?
No.
You didn't see the blood on his arm or anything?
No, I didn't.
After they attended the water fountain, you testified that you heard Mrs. Stevens say, "Let it go or leave it alone."
Yes.
Could he have been referring to his wound?
I don't know.
You don't know if when he said, "Let it alone," he could have been talking about his wound? Yes or no?
Objection, Your Honor, no personal knowledge.
Overruled. Continue with the question.
Could you answer the question, please?
No.
He couldn't have been talking about his wound.
No.
Why not? If he was saying leave it alone, can he be talking about his wound?
Counselor, we instructed the witness to answer yes or no. You can not ask questions that are need more knowledge than yes or no.
Okay. After they got to the water fountain, did you resume looking at your magazine?
Yes, I did.
Is it true the arcade is dimly lit?
Yes.
Isn't it true that you weren't really paying attention because you were looking at this magazine?
No.
May I have a 10-second?
Yes, you may.
Yes, yes.
Before we proceed, Counselor, I need you to speak up so everyone can hear you.
Okay. Did Mr. Mann reach behind his back and make the motion of pulling something out of his back pocket?
Yes.
In a dimly lit place, you can't really see what that... defendant might not have been able to see what that was, could you?
No.
Mrs. Cervantes, when you caught up with Mr. Stevens, did he make any attempts to run away?
No.
Isn't it true the only reason that you caught up to Mr. Stevens was because he hesitated and didn't know where he was going?
Yes.
Did Mr. Stevens fight with you, kick with you, argue with you, scratch you when you nabbed him?
No.
Isn't it true that Mr. Stevens came back willingly?
Yes.
And isn't it true that Mr. Stevens admitted to you, saying, I just had to do it?
Yes.
Isn't that possible he had to do it for self-defense?
He could have.
Yes or no?
Objection, Your Honor, no personal knowledge.
Sustained. Jury, please disregard that question and answer. Continue, Counselor.
No further questions.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Fontes, you may set the jury down. Prosecution, would you like to call another witness?
Yes, I would, Your Honor. I would like to call Dr. Agnes Chin to the stand, please.
Okay, Dr. Agnes Chin, would you please approach the stand? Bailiff, would you please swear this witness in?
Raise your hand. As long as you give it, I'm going to give it as a joke. Say I will.
I will.
Say your full name and say your last.
Agnes Chin, C-H-E-N.
May I approach the witness, Your Honor?
Yes, you may.
Could you please state your full name to the court?
Agnes Chin.
Please state your occupation.
I'm a doctor at County Hospital.
Ms. Chin, what do you do in the hospital?
I work with patients in emergency room.
Mrs. Chin, what comes to your mind when you think of trauma?
Objection, Your Honor, Pina.
Overruled. Continue with that question.
The counselors and the witnesses have to speak up.
Okay, counselor, witnesses, we need you to speak up so everyone can hear.
I'll repeat it again. Ms. Chin, what comes to your mind when you think of the word trauma?
Objection, irrelevant to the case.
Overruled. Continue with the question.
Trauma, like something bad happening or...
Ms. Chin, could you tell the court what hours you worked the night of June 4th?
6:30 p.m. to 6:30 a.m.
And during this time, did you see a marked man brought in?
Yes, I did.
Can you tell the court what time he was brought in?
After 9 p.m.
Do you know Martin Mann?
No, I don't.
Do you know Brad Stevens?
No, I don't.
Would you lie for either one?
No.
Can you tell the court the physical state Martin was in?
He suffered extreme blows to the nose and to the cartridge in his nose.
Your Honor, may I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may.
Thank you. Mrs. Chin, are you a good doctor?
Yes, I am.
What makes you a good one?
Overruled. Continue with the question.
Mrs. Chin, what makes you a good doctor?
I like helping others in the emergency room and elsewhere.
Mrs. Chin, do you see many broken noses?
Yes, I do.
How does the one of Martin Mann compare to others?
Objection, rebelling to the case.
Sustained. Jury, disregard that question. Counselor, continue with another question.
Your Honor, may I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may.
Honor, could you the witness to stop harassing the counselor?
You're not allowed to talk, Brad. We need to continue, counselors.
Mrs. Chin, you've told us that the cartilage and Martin Mann's nose.
Objection, Your Honor, leading question.
Overruled. Continue with the question.
You told us that the cartilage in Martin Mann's nose was crushed. Is this correct?
Yes.
So it was really bad?
Yes.
Have you ever seen anything like it before?
Objection. Speculation.
Sustained. Disregard the answer.
So this injury was really serious?
Yes.
Objection, Your Honor. She's already asked these questions before.
Asked and
rephrasing. She just rephrasing.
Overrule. Continue.
I'll repeat it again. So this injury was really serious?
Yes.
What did you recommend for this type of injury?
Immediate emergency operation.
Was it performed?
Yes, it was.
Your Honor, may I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may. We need to make this one 10 seconds, too, so we can continue with the case. Go ahead.
Ms. Chin, so I understand this injury was really serious.
Yes.
Thank you, Your Honor. I have no further questions.
Okay. Defense, would you like to cross-examine this witness?
Yes, Your Honor. May I approach the witness?
Yes, you may.
Good morning, Ms. Chin. Just relax. Just tell the truth. Your Honor, could you instruct the witness to answer yes or no to my questions?
Yes. Mrs. Chin, would you please answer yes or no to all questions? Yes.
Doctor, how many years have you been practicing medicine?
12 years.
Have you ever seen a nose broken as bad as this one?
No, I haven't.
In your 12 years of being a doctor, you haven't seen a nose broken as bad as this one?
No, I haven't.
Not in car accidents?
No.
Not any type of accident?
Objection, Your Honor, irrelevant.
Sustained. Jury, disregard the question and answer. Continue, Counselor.
May I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may. Okay, counselors, we need to continue. Excuse me. We need to continue.
Could you instruct the witness to answer my questions? Yes, or no?
Yes. Would you please answer all questions? Yes or no?
Doctor, were you then at the arcade the night of June 4th?
No, I wasn't.
Did you see my client hit Mr. Mann?
I wasn't there.
Yes or no?
Yes.
No.
So you can't really testify to anything except for the nose is broken?
Right.
Not how it was broken, just that the nose was broken.
Yes.
No further questions.
Okay, thank you. May I step down, Ms. Chen? Prosecution, do you have any more witnesses to bring up at this moment in time?
No, Your Honor. Prosecution, right.
Okay, thank you. Defense, we are now ready to have your witnesses come up. Would you please call your first witness?
Your Honor, the defense would like to call Mr. Sidney Berg.
Okay, Mr. Sidney Berg, would you please approach the stand? Bailiff, please swear this witness in.
Raise your hand. You solemnly swear that testimony you give is the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. Say hello. Say your full name and swear your lies.
Sidney Berg.
Put your seat.
May I please call the witness, Your Honor?
Yes, you may.
Good morning, Mr. Berg. I know you're feeling a little nervous right now. Please try to answer your questions to the best of your knowledge and with a loud voice so everyone can hear.
Alright.
Mr. Berg, do you work?
Yeah, I do.
And where do you work at?
I'm the manager at the Big Wheels Motorcycle Shop.
Do you know Mr. Brad Stevens?
Yeah, he works for me.
Is he in the courtroom today?
Yeah, he's right there.
Your Honor, please let the record indicate that he has identified Mr. Brad Stevens.
The record will show that. We need you all to speak up loud and clear so everyone can hear in the back of the courtroom too, please.
How long has Mr. Stevens been working at the motorcycle shop?
About 3 months.
Mr. Berg, what position did you hire Mr. Stevens as?
A stock clerk.
Does he still maintain that position?
No, he got a promotion.
Why was Mr. Stevens promoted?
Because I liked what he was doing.
Would you have promoted anyone that has put in the type of work Mr. Stevens has?
Yeah, if they do the work, then I'll promote them.
Mr. Berg, did you offer any type of special treatment to Mr. Stevens in his promotion?
No.
Mr. Berg, what do you look for in your employees?
Just good, hardworking employees.
Objection, Your Honor, irrelevant to the case.
Overruled. Continue with the question.
Mr. Berg, what do you look for in your employees?
Good, hardworking employees. Do the job good.
Has Mr. Stevens provided you with that type of work?
Yeah.
Mr. Berg, are you a very strict person?
No. But I just say
objection,
no.
Your Honor, calls for an opinion.
Overruled. Continue with the question.
Are you a very strict person, Mr.
No, but if they don't do the work, then they're going to have to get fired, you know?
Do your employees often come and go?
Yeah.
Mr. Berg, do you know what perjury is?
Uh-huh.
Do you know what the penalty for perjury is?
Yeah, I could go to jail.
Mr. Berg. Mr. Berg, would you ever lie to protect Mr. Stevens or any of your other employees that is being prosecuted?
No.
From your experience, Mr. Berg, what type of person is Mr. Stevens?
He's a good kid.
Objection, Your Honor, calls for an opinion.
Overruled. Continue with the question, counsel.
From your experience, Mr. Berg, what type of person is Mr. Stevens?
He's a good kid. Doesn't look like he'd do anything bad.
How do your employees behave in your store?
They're good. They don't like start no problems or nothing.
Is Mr. Stevens also like that?
No, he's kind of quiet. Like, keeps himself a little bit.
Mr. Berg, has a customer ever complained about Mr. Stevens?
No.
Has a coworker ever complained about Mr. Stevens?
No.
Has Mr. Stevens ever caused you trouble while working for him?
No, not at all.
Have you ever seen him get into a fight with anyone?
No.
Have you ever seen him try to start a fight with someone?
No, he doesn't look like the kind of kid that would start fights.
Can I have 10 seconds?
Yes, you may.
No further questions, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you. Prosecution, would you like to cross-examine this witness?
I say what, Your Honor. May I cross the witness?
Yes, you may.
Your Honor, would you ask the witness to answer all questions with yes or no?
Would you ask answer all questions yes or no?
Mr. Berg, you're the manager at the Big Wheel Motorcycle Shop, is that correct?
Yes.
And that's located in Westdale?
Yes.
And Mr. Stevens is a sales clerk, correct?
Yes.
Without your employees, you really wouldn't have a business, would you?
Yeah.
So you wouldn't need any employees to run your business?
Objection, you're relevant to the case.
Overruled. Continue with the question.
You need your sales clerks to run your business, correct?
Yeah.
And if you lose one of those sales clerks, it would hurt your business, correct?
No.
No?
No.
May I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may.
Mr. Berg, if Mr. Stevens is found guilty, he will be fired, correct?
Yeah.
So isn't the real reason you're here is to make sure Mr. Stevens doesn't get fired?
No.
No?
No.
Mr. Berg, do you know the penalty for perjury?
Yeah.
Objection, irrelevant. You just already stated it in his direct testimony.
Overruled. Yeah. Continue with that question, Counselor.
You do know the penalty for perjury?
Yes, I do.
May I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may.
Mr. Berg, you don't know Mr. Stevens personally, do you? I mean, you don't know, it's like, besides his work, you don't know.
No, I don't.
So you wouldn't know if he, how he was, what he was like, other than when he worked, correct?
Yeah.
No further questions, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you. You may step down, Mr. Berg. Defense, would you like to call your next witness?
The defense would like to call Ms. Jacqueline Lombardi.
Jacqueline Lombardi, would you please approach the stand? Bailiff, would you please swear this witness in?
Raise your hand. You solemnly swear that testimony gives the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, bailiff. Is there a full name? Call your last.
Jacqueline Lombardi, B-A-R-D-I-E.
Your Honor, may I please talk to
you? Yes, you may.
Good morning, Ms. Lombardi. Ms. Barty, do you go to school?
Yes.
And what school is that?
South High School.
Do you know Mr. Brad Stevens?
Yes, I do.
Is he present in the courtroom today?
Yes, he is.
Can you identify him?
Yes, he's right there.
Your Honor, please let the record indicate she has identified Mr. Brad Stevens.
Record will show that.
From your experience, what type of person is Mr. Stevens?
He's quiet.
Ms. Barty, do you know what perjury is?
Yes.
Do you know what the penalty for perjury is?
Yes, I do.
And would you commit perjury to protect Mr. Stevens?
No.
What were you doing on June 4th at approximately 7:30 p.m.?
I was at Melanie's Video Arcade.
Who did you go to the arcade with?
A couple friends.
Why did you go to the arcade that night?
Just to hang out and try and, you know, see people.
Were you playing video games?
I played a couple, but...
About how long were you playing video games?
You know, like 15 minutes.
And what did you do after that?
I went to go get a soda.
And can you indicate on the map where you went?
Right there at the counter, and I was standing by the basket.
I'm sure nobody in the back room heard that. Could you please repeat your answer and speak up?
I was standing by the counter, and I was standing by the trash can.
And where, in comparison to the front doorway of the store, is the counter?
It's about, like, I don't know, like 10 feet or so.
What did you see when you were at the camp?
Some people are complaining they can't hear, so can you speak into it?
Let's move the chair over.
Wait.
Yeah.
Why didn't I think of that?
That's
fair. What did you see when you were at the camp?
I saw Tanya and Brad. They were at the water fountain.
And what were they doing?
She was holding the water and he was rinsing off his hand.
And was Mr. Stevens' hand bleeding?
I can't really tell, but he had his hand under the water.
Okay. What happened after Mr. Stevens had stopped washing his hand?
I saw Ms. Cook and Mr. Mann walking towards them.
How were Mr. Mann and Ms. Cook walking?
Real fast.
What was Mr. Mann's state of mind?
He looked real angry.
Objection, Your Honor, calls for an opinion.
Sustained. Jury, please disregard that question. Continue with another question.
What was going on at that point?
I couldn't tell, but they were going after him, like coming towards him.
So Mr. Mann was walking fast toward Mr. Stevens, And Mr. Mann was going to attack Mr. Stevens.
Sustain. Sustain, please. Disregard that question, jury.
Ms. Barty, why did you think Mr. Mann was going to do something?
Because he looked mad.
And did Mr. Mann reach for his pocket?
Yes, he did.
At that point, did you fear for Mr. Stevens' safety?
Yeah.
Objection, Your Honor.
Overruled. Continue.
Ms. Barty, do you recall what Mr. Mann was wearing that night?
Yeah, he was wearing a shirt with his name on it.
How about Mr. Stevens?
He was wearing an orange t-shirt.
And what about Ms. Cook?
She was wearing this tube top with little hands.
And Ms. Morgan?
She was wearing like a skirt and a yellow top.
Can I have a 10 seconds?
Yes, you may.
No further questions, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you. Prosecution, would you like to cross-examine this witness?
You would, Your Honor. May I approach the witness?
Yes, you may. Please speak loudly and clearly so everyone can hear you.
Your Honor, would you ask the witness to answer all questions with yes or no?
Yes, would you please answer all questions yes or no? Yes.
Ms. Barty, you're a student at South High School, is that correct?
Yes.
And you've known Mr. Stevens for a while?
Yes.
And you've also dated him a few times, correct?
Yes.
And other than at school and dating, you don't really know him personally, correct?
No.
And you were ready to go with him again, but he stopped calling you, correct?
Yes.
After Mr. Stevens washed his hand, and you saw Mr. Mann and Ms. Cook walking fast towards Mr. Stevens, right?
Yes.
So you saw Mr. Mann and Ms. Cook crossing towards Mr. Stevens.
Yes.
And Mr. Mann looked like he was going to do something to Mr. Stevens.
Yes.
But Mr. Mann didn't do anything, did he?
No.
When Mr. Stevens struck Mr. Mann, you couldn't believe it, could you?
Yeah.
But it did startle you, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And Mr. Stevens then dropped the piece of wood and ran, correct?
Yes.
You say you can recall what everybody was wearing, right?
Yes.
But you didn't see a knife, did you?
No.
When Mr. Stevens was waiting for the police, you tried talking to him, didn't you?
Yes.
And he didn't say anything, did he?
No.
If Mr. Stevens was innocent, wouldn't you think he would tell you that
Objection
he was innocent?
Objection, irrelevant to the case.
Sustain, jury, disregard that question. Continue, counselor.
May I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may.
You did see Mr. Stevens strike Mr. Mann, correct?
No.
You didn't see Mr. Stevens strike Mr. Mann?
Oh, yes, yes.
And he used this piece of wood, correct?
Yeah.
Did Mr. Mann ask Mr. Stevens to strike him?
No.
Objection, no personal knowledge.
Overruled. Continue with that question.
Did Mr. Mann ask Mr. Stevens to strike him?
No.
Objection, hearsay.
Overruled. Continue, counselor.
When Mr. Stevens was waiting for the police, did he say, or did he do anything, did he like tell anybody that he was innocent?
No.
No? No further questions, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you. Ms. Lombardi, or Barty, you may sit down. Defense, would you like to call your next witness?
The defense would like to call Ms. Tanya Morgan.
Okay, Tanya Morgan, would you please approach the stand? Bailiff, could you please swear this witness in?
Raise your right hand. You solemnly swear that testimony gives you the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. Say, I will.
I will.
Say your full name and swear your last.
Tanya Morgan, M-O-R-G-A-N.
Say, proceed.
May I please approach the witness?
Yes, you may. Can you please bring the microphone in, or we can have someone?
Good morning, Ms. Morgan.
Good morning.
Thank you.
Ms. Morgan, do you know what perjury is?
Yes.
You know the penalty for perjury?
Yes.
Did you ever commit perjury?
No.
Ms. Morgan, do you go to school?
Yes.
And what school is that?
South High School.
Excuse me, counselor, let's just... Yes.
And can you repeat what school is that?
South South High School.
And what school does Mr. Stevens attend?
South High School.
Ms. Morgan, from your experience, what type of person is Mr. Stevens?
He's a nice guy.
Objection, Your Honor, cost your opinion.
Objection overruled. Continue with the question.
Ms. Morgan, from your experience, what type of person is Mr. Stevens?
He is quiet and shy.
Ms. Morgan, would you lie to protect Mr. Stevens from any dangers or troubles?
No. I've only known him for a while, and I wouldn't commit perjury.
What were you doing on June 4th at around 7:30 p.m.?
Brad was picking me up at my house.
And was this your first date?
Yes.
What were you doing? Okay. Where did you go?
We went to Melanie's Video Arcade.
And what were you doing at the arcade?
Playing Frogger.
And then what happened?
And then Mr. Stevens ran out of quarters.
And what happened next?
We went to the quarter machine to get change.
And then what happened?
When we came back, Martin Mann and Connie Cook were on the Frogger game.
And then what?
Then Mr. Stevens told Mr. Mann that we were there first, and why didn't he go play another game?
What was Mr. Mann's state of mind while saying these words?
Objection, Your Honor. No personal knowledge.
Sustained. Jury, please disregard that question.
What happened next?
Mr. Mann said, no, why don't you go play another game?
And what happened after that?
Mr. Mann pushed Mr. Stevens down to the ground.
So let me get this right. Mr. Mann pushed Mr. Stevens down, is that correct?
Yes.
And what happened to Mr. Stevens?
He hurt his wrist and his hand.
Was Mr. Stevens laying on his back while on the ground?
Yes.
As Mr. Stevens was on his back, what did Mr. Mann do?
He was going forward to him, and I had to hold him back.
Was he trying to come after him?
Yes.
So you're saying you were restraining Mr. Mann from doing further harm to a defenseless Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
What happened when you were trying to restrain Mr. Mann?
Mr. Mann told Mr. Stevens, if I ever see you again, I'll beat you up.
So Mr. Mann specifically said, and I quote, if I see you again, I'll beat you up, is that correct?
Yes.
What was Mr. Mann's state of mind as he said these
Objection,
words?
Objection, Your Honor, no personal knowledge.
Sustained. Jury, disregard that question.
And what happened next?
I helped up Mr. Stevens and we walked over to the water fountain.
Can you indicate on the map where the water fountain is?
It's right here.
And where is that in comparison to the front of the door? So the front doorway of the store.
To the right?
Is it right next to it?
Yes.
Okay, now, right now, you said you need to say, let the record show that the front door and the water fountain are very close to each other. If this case is ever appealed, they need to know that in the record.
Your Honor, please let the record show that the front door is next to the fountain.
The record will show that.
What happened as you were helping Mr. Stevens walk?
Mr. Mann came towards us, was walking towards us.
And what was Mr. Mann's state of mind at this point?
He was very...
Objection, Your Honor, no personal knowledge.
Sustained. Jury, disregard that question.
Was Mr. Mann angry?
Yes.
What was this... Was this the next time you and Mr. Stevens, had seen Mr. Mann after he had threatened you?
Yes.
As Mr. Mann and Ms. Cook were walking toward you, what happened?
Mr. Mann was pulling something out of his pocket.
Could this have been what he pulled out of his pocket?
Yes.
Could you make out what was in his hand, actually?
No.
Could it have been this?
Yes.
In one word, please summarize how you felt.
Scared.
What went through your mind that this was happening?
I thought Mr. Mann was going to...
Objection, Your Honor, calls for a conclusion.
Overruled. Continue with the question.
What went through your mind as this was happening?
I thought Mr. Mann was going to beat up Mr. Stevens.
Let me get this straight. Mr. Mann was walking towards you and Mr. Stevens in an angrily and fast pace. This had been the next time Mr. Mann had seen Mr. Stevens and after threatening him, and Mr. Mann reached for his pocket for what could have been a knife?
Yes.
And what happened next?
Mr. Stevens picked up a wood from the windowsill.
And is this the piece of wood that he picked up?
Yes.
Then what happened?
He swung it at Mr. Mann.
Now, at what point did he swing at Mr. Mann?
When Mr. Mann seemed to be coming towards him.
Miss Morgan, can you tell the court how many hands Mr. Stevens used on the wood to strike Mr.
Just one.
And which hand was that?
His left.
Can I have a 10-second please?
Yes, you may. That's short.
When what?
Taking a recess,
Miss Morgan, were you scared of Mr. Mann attacking you?
Yes.
And how many times did Mr. Stevens swing at Mr. Mann?
Once.
No further questions, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you. Prosecution, would you like to cross-examine this witness?
Yes, Your Honor, may I
yes, you may.
Your Honor, would you ask the witness to answer all questions with yes or no?
Would you please answer all questions yes or no?
Yes.
Ms. Morgan, you're a student at South High, is that correct?
Yes.
And Mr. Stevens asked you out on June 4th, is that correct?
Yes.
So you really didn't know him other than a little bit
of school until
he asked you out.
Wait, Your Honor, we need to order in court. We can't
okay,
do that.
We need to have the minimum commotion as possible so we can hear the counselor and the witness speaking. Go ahead with your
other
question.
Other than Mr. Stevens asking you out, you really didn't know any of his personal life.
No.
When you and Mr. Stevens returned from the change machine, Mr. Mann and Ms. Cook were at your machine, correct?
Yes.
And Mr. Stevens was angry at Mr. Mann, wasn't he?
Objection, possible opinion.
No.
Okay, we need you to speak, like, out there, so,
we can't do
yeah.
that because you're directing your questions just to her. You have to direct them out in this case.
We had an objection. Overruled. Continue with the question.
And Mr. Stevens was angry at Mr. Mann for being at his machine.
No.
No? So what did Mr. Stevens do? He tried to force Mr. Mann away from
objection.
The machine.
Being the witness.
Objection overruled. Continue
objection,
with the
Honor.
Question.
Mr. Yes. Mann?
I overruled that objection, Counselor. You can continue with the question.
Mr.
Order.
Mr. Mann did
in the
try
court.
To force Mr.
Please.
Stevens away from the machine.
Yes.
And Mr. Mann told Mr. Stevens that he was using the machine, right?
Yes.
And then Mr. Stevens tried to use the machine again, didn't he?
No.
He didn't, after Mr. Mann told him it was his machine, he didn't try to
order in the court, please.
His machine again?
No.
After Mr. Stevens tried to force Mr. Mann away from the machine, didn't you feel that he was kind of going too far about this machine?
Objection, cause for an opinion.
Can I have two counselors, or one counselor from each side, please approach the bench?
Right now, the judge has a pretty important question, so the judge doesn't want the jury to hear what he's. They're going to each try to explain the
okay.
Didn't you feel that Mr. Stevens was going too far when he tried to force Mr. Mann away from the machine?
No, that caused a civil case, and what it doesn't prove nothing, plus it caused an opinion. I mean, what is it? What purpose does it serve? It's irrelevant, plus it costs more opinion. What purpose does it serve in this case?
Okay, see, I'm looking for facts only here.
Yeah.
That's true, right?
And that's speculation. And you must, based on all the facts, and the speculation, it must be relevant to the case, and that's not relevant to the case.
Okay.
Sure?
Yes. Okay, the question you were asking, Counselor, it's going to be sustained. Jury, please disregard the question.
Then Mr. Mann pushed Mr. Stevens, correct?
Yes.
And then Mr. Mann came towards Mr. Stevens.
Yes.
You didn't know what Mr. Mann was thinking, did you?
No.
So you didn't know if Mr. Mann was going to hurt Mr. Stevens or help him, did you?
No.
When you and Mr. Stevens saw Mr. Mann and Miss Cook walking quickly towards you, you said he had something in his hand, correct?
Yes.
Was it a knife? Like this knife right here?
I don't know.
Or was it a wallet like this?
I don't know.
Objection. Did you ask me questions of yes or no?
Yes. I instructed the witness to answer questions yes or no, so you need to ask questions that refer to a yes or no answer.
Or was it a knife like this?
No.
Or was it a wallet like this?
No. Objection. Objection. No personal knowledge.
Overruled. Continue with the question.
I can't.
So it wasn't a knife.
No.
When Mr. Mann got close to you, did he say anything to Mr. Stevens?
No.
So you thought he had a knife, but he didn't say to Mr. Stevens. You thought Mr. Mann had a knife, right?
Yes.
But you didn't tell Mr. Stevens that you think he has a knife or anything like that?
No.
When Mr. Stevens struck Mr. Mann, you were startled, weren't you?
Speak up,
yes.
Counselor. Loud.
And when Mr. Stevens dropped the piece of wood, he ran, and he didn't say anything to you. He just ran out of the door.
Yes.
And he ran like he was fleeing from some sort of a crime.
Objection. Cause for an opinion.
Sustained. Jury disregard that question.
Okay. Miss Morgan, when Mr. Cervantes brought Mr. Stevens back, he had a really nervous, guilty look on his face.
Objection, cause of speculation.
Sustained. Jury, disregard that question. Continue with another question. I need order in the court, please. We need to hear the counselor and the witness.
May I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may.
Mr. Mann didn't ask Mr. Stevens to hit him with the
order in the court, please.
Wood,
counselor, can you please repeat your question?
Mr. Mann didn't ask Mr. Stevens to strike him with the
objection.
Wood,
ability to the case.
Overruled. Continue with your question, counselor.
And, when Mr. Stevens hit Mr. Mann, if he was using self-defense, did he at least stay and explain to Mr. Cervantes that he was using self-defense?
Objection. Compound question.
Overworld, continue with the question.
Did Mr. Stevens explain to Mr. Cervantes that he was using self-defense?
Objection, no personal knowledge.
No.
So he just ran out without saying one word.
Counselor, I need to break in here. I need one counselor from each side, please, to approach the bench.
Ask Mr. Mann to hit him?
No. When there is an objection, you need to wait, and then when I give you the need to proceed, that's when you can proceed. But ask the question that you wrote, that they've been overruled again, and then we'll deal from there. But I need, if it's overruled, move to another question or try and restate your question. But we need to, when there's an objection, we need to stop and see what we can do, and then proceed. So. I'm going to overrule your question so you can continue with another question. The last objection was overruled, and you can continue.
Ms. Morgan, Mr. Stevens did strike Mr. Mann with this piece of wood, didn't he?
Yes.
And Mr. Stevens did, or Mr. Mann did fall to the ground, and he was in real pain, wasn't
Objection,
he?
Objection, speculation.
Sustained. Jury, disregard the question. Continue with another question, counsel.
May I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may.
Okay.
When Mr. Stevens struck Mr. Mann, did you do anything to try to help Mr. Mann?
Objection, Your Honor. He asked the witness to answer yes or no.
That is yes. Order in the court. I don't need any side conversations or speculations from any of the witnesses. Overruled. Continue with your question, counsel.
When Mr. Stevens struck Mr. Mann, did you do anything to help Mr. Mann?
Yes.
You did. Before Mr. Stevens struck Mr. Mann, did you try to get Mr. Stevens to run rather than hit Mr. Mann?
Can you repeat the question, please?
I need you to speak up, counsel, because I know that they can't hear you. And can you please repeat the question that was objected to?
When Mr. Stevens struck before Mr. Stevens struck Mr. Mann, did you try to try to run, or did you just stay there?
So you asked no question, right?
Yeah.
Did I run or did I stay?
Did you run or did you just stay?
It's a yes or no question.
No, I said yes. Did you call me?
Question here.
Okay.
Yes, I stayed.
Sustained. Jury, disregard that question. Continue with another question.
When you saw Mr. Mann coming at you, did you try to just run away from Mr. Mann?
You just sustained.
No. No further questions, Your Honor.
Thank you. You may step down. Yes. Right now? Okay. How many? Okay, we're going to have a 10-minute recess right now. At this point, we need no conversing with the jury members, and you may all get up and have a 10-minute recess to go to the bathroom or whatever. We'll be back here.
Okay, good job.